cruising, ladies and gentlemen. 5 miles today. Ah, it feels so good to go just a little bit further. Taking the Vomero 14s out for the spin today, and the full review is coming up pretty soon. I want to do maybe another 15 to 20 miles in the Vomero 14s before the full review comes, so that's coming. And also, I know a lot of you have been asking about my Salomon jacket, and basically it has not been cold enough in Denver this winter, but I think I'm gonna call it. I think I'm just gonna give you my thoughts and my review, not today, but probably maybe Thursday or Friday, all right? And because I don't know, we might just have a mild winter this year in Denver, and I wanna get you the full review of the Salomon jacket before the snow is all gone. Like, I know it's only January, but who knows? Who knows what's gonna happen? All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's go 5 miles steady. Not steezy, not easy, but steady. I'll maybe talk about that later. All right, here we go. There we go. All right, I'm back. 5 miles, 5 miles, 7 minutes a mile. For everyone outside the United States that uses kilometers, I'm gonna do better in 2019, communicating as often as possible in kilometers, because I know that's how really most of the world measures distance. So 4 minutes and 20 seconds per kilometer. All right, 4 minutes and 20 seconds per kilometer for that 5 mile run. That's, you know, a steady pace for me at this point in the training. Definitely the fastest I've gone in 2019 since coming off the break. And I won't go that fast again. Let's see, it's until Friday. So 5 days from now, all right? So that's kind of my slow progression, getting the waking the legs up to a little more speed. Okay, just working now, and then we'll check back in a little bit. Oh man, oh, the shoes arrived. I don't know what they are. I don't know what they are. Mystery shoe coming up, so stay tuned for that. Running a few quick errands this afternoon on my way to the post office. Check that P.O. box, see what's in there. You never know. I like to check it every 3 or 4 days. You never know, YouTube. Sure enough, a box arrived at the P.O. box, 1972. Let's see here. Hold on. You guys are amazing. Oh, whoa. Hello. Oh my, it's a t-shirt. Oh boy. Well, something arrived in the P.O. box. It's a t-shirt. We got the Denver Broncos, I believe. It's a football t-shirt, but it's really comfortable. And it's made by Hylete, I think. H-Y-L-E-T-E. Anyway, I don't know who sent it to me. Whoever sent this to me, thank you. I couldn't really find it in the packaging. Bottom line, I'm appreciative. And shout out to the Denver Broncos, even though this is a running-focused YouTube channel. For everybody outside the United States, that is a football team here in Denver, Colorado. Okay, we're going inside to eat dinner, and then I'm going to come back out, talk to you about the new running shoes that arrived and all that good stuff. Woo! But don't block the camera. Here we go. Say Skechers! Well, if I'm just being honest, I would have to say my high for the day was perhaps getting a new pair of running shoes.
Oh my goodness!
Hey-o!
Whoa! Who's that from?
Well, us.
From us!
From us!
Yay, us! There's been so many coming in lately from other souls.
Right?
Thank you. Okay.
Boys, what do you guys think of all of Papa's running shoes? Is it getting a little out of control?
Mm-hmm. All the fun with them. In the car, they're in that bag, and you got new ones today. We should set all of them out and maybe count them.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
And tell them?
Count them.
Count them. Mmm. Mom, are you okay with my run and shoot collection?
Oh, yes. Yes, I am. DeMoor, the merrier.
As we like to say at the DeMoor household, DeMoor, the merrier. DeMoor, the merrier, shoes. There we go. There we go. The Skechers Go Run Razor 3 is now in my possession. And frankly, it's all because of you and all of you out there who encouraged me to maintain an open mind about Skechers. Frankly, I never thought I'd be owning a racing shoe from Skechers, but here you go. There it is. And we're going to talk about that in a minute. But first, I do just want to make a couple shout outs to Max, to Alan, to Michael, to Riley, to Logan, to Alex again, to Scott, to William. These are all Chris. These are all people who have joined up on Strava just in the last like 3 or 4 hours. And I just need to mention that this is not a traditional running shoe review YouTube experience, okay? This is a daily vlog where I share a little slice of my life with people on YouTube. And in addition, I happen to love running. And a lot of you have figured out that, gosh, this guy really, really loves running and he loves talking about running gear. And so I like to think that I'm trying to bring as much value as possible to the running world, but doing it in a unique way. Because, you know, there's a lot of running gear channels out there. There's a lot of training channels, a lot of injury prevention running YouTube channels. But I like to take the approach of sharing my story with you and my journey to my first marathon, which is, yes, gonna tie into the discussion about the Razor 3 tonight. And so that's why it probably took 3, 4, 5 minutes to get to this point in the video where we start actually talking about shoes. You saw me in there eating dinner with my family. And so anyway, I just want to put that out there to all, because I think some people probably land on these videos and these vlogs and they're like, wait a minute, where's like the gear review? Where's the shoe review? Like, get to it, cut to the chase. And it's just not that type of YouTube channel. So just want to put that out there for everybody that's now subscribed and is following me on Strava. Okay, ask and you shall receive. Ask and you shall receive. A lot of you in the last 6 to 8 weeks said, Seth, you have to try the Razor 3. And again, I was skeptical, but I made the plunge. Last week I said, okay, we're gonna get it. We're gonna order it and see what happens. And so I'm excited to give it a shot. And I must say, just right out of the box, incredibly lightweight. This shoe has a 4 millimeter drop, and weighs 6.4 ounces. And guess what? I looked it up ahead of time. It's 181 grams. 181 grams for everyone outside the United States. I don't even know how to comprehend that number, but for everyone in the US, 6.4 ounces for this shoe. And I am a little concerned about the midsole, just like holding it and just kind of running my thumb over the midsole. It's, you know what it feels like? It feels like a noodle at a pool. You know how you sit in a pool and you float on a noodle? It kind of has that feel to it. And I'm exaggerating a little bit, but even just looking at it, it kind of looks like a pool noodle. All right, so those are a few initial impressions, just kind of coming out of the box. Has some tougher rubber through the outsole to help protect the midsole. And this midsole is a pretty big update from the Razor 2. They're calling it the Hyperburst. That's right, the Hyperburst midsole, or the Hyperburst foam. And it should be longer lasting compared to the Razor 2. It's 15% lighter than the Razor 2. That's a really great jump forward from one iteration to the next. So from the 2 to the 3. And I guess it's, again, supposed to be definitely the lightest option on the Skechers, the Skechers lineup right now. So that's good news. And I'm not going to talk about the upper. We'll get to that in future videos. I'm just kind of looking at it right now. We'll get to that in future videos. And before we dive into these shoes, I want to just mention a story that came through in the comments, I think 3 or 4 days ago. Basically, it's a tough story. A gentleman is he's a teacher, and he shared his story in the comments. I don't remember his name, sorry about that, but I do know he's a teacher in a challenging neighborhood in Los Angeles. And he basically was thanking me for doing a video, probably 6 weeks ago on this shoe, this other Skechers shoe that I have. And basically the title of the video was, something along the lines of affordable running shoes. And this teacher communicated to me in the comments that he really appreciated that video because his kids at the school can't go buy a $250 running shoe or a $150 running shoe. Where's a, like, this guy is $130, this Skechers Razor 3. Like, that is outside of the price point for the kids that he coaches and helps and mentors and inspires in LA. And so just a shout out to that gentleman for being there for the kids. And I hope, like, listen, I, as I've mentioned before, I don't need all these shoes. I realize that. But again, I'm trying to bring you as much value through these shoe reviews while still understanding that, yeah, like, this shoe was $68 and it's a good shoe. I'm not gonna say it's a great shoe, but guess what? This Skechers shoe, it'll get the job done. And if you're like a high schooler and you're struggling with your, you know, to pay for a pair of shoes, like, listen, keep fighting. Like, don't give up. Like, keep working hard. And yeah, like, someday, it's taken me 20 years of running to be in a position to be able to purchase a certain amount of running shoes on an annual basis. Like, we're on a budget. True Love and I, we're on a budget. You saw True Love there at the dinner table. Like, I just can't go willy-nilly, even though it might look like it at times. So I digress. I just wanted to mention that story. And I think it's just so inspiring that this gentleman is like helping the kids and like putting out there to the world, like, listen, not everybody can afford new running shoes all the time. So bottom line, let's be grateful for the shoes we have, right? That's the message at the end of the day. Whether they're $70 shoes, $68, or the New Balance Zante version 4 for $34. That's right, picked up this guy for $34. I digress. Oh, just so inspiring. Thank you for sharing your story. Thank you. And on that note about running shoes, like I said, I have a budget. I have it detailed out, like what I'm going to be buying in 2019. And yes, there's one more shoe coming up very soon that is a road racing shoe. Road racing shoe. Stay tuned. I think you're going to be excited about it. And yes, a lot of you have asked me to review the shoe, but also to compare the shoe to the Vaporfly 4%. And I am very excited for the question of the day. I want to hear your opinions. And I know for a fact I haven't asked the question exactly the way I'm going to ask it. But again, I know a lot of you are training for marathons coming up in 2019. And so I'm excited, road marathons specifically. And so I'm excited to hear your comments on the question of the day. But the Skechers Razor 3, yeah, I'm interested. Will it be a marathon racing shoe? I don't know. Will it beat out the Vaporfly 4%? I don't know. But frankly, just holding the shoes in my hands right now, the Razor 3 is winning as far as weight goes. Like, I can just feel it right now in my hands. And I know the Vaporfly 4% completely changed the running shoe market in 2018 with a carbon fiber plate inside the midsole. Completely revolutionized road racing. And I would be interested to hear your thoughts on which running shoe company do you think moving forward is going to put in a carbon fiber plate. Honestly, it's revolutionary, this shoe. I don't know if the other companies will be able to compete, and I don't want to say survive, if they don't put a carbon fiber plate in their shoes. Alarm bells for Reebok, for Asics, for Brooks, for Adidas, for Saucony, for every New Balance, the list goes on. Like, those are alarm bells, ladies and gentlemen. So I would be curious to hear your thoughts on who will be doing the carbon fiber plate moving forward. All right, the keyword of the day is road. That's right, road, for road racing. And my question of the day, what should be a running shoe, a racing flat that I consider for my first marathon in 2019? And what will be your racing flat for your marathon or half marathon in 2019? Thank you for answering, and thanks for just sharing your ideas about racing flats, because I am a trail runner who is transitioning back to the roads. And so I'm trying to figure out, like, what's the best option? Razor 3, Zante 4. I know this is not going to be the option, but just putting it out there. Zante 4, the fast twitch, huh? The fast twitch. I'm thinking this is more 10K, but you never know. You never know. I'm keeping my options open. Or the Vaporfly 4%, or maybe it's the mystery shoe that'll be showing up at my house soon. All right, that's all I got. That's all I got. Thanks for bearing with me through some of those side stories. I just love communicating with you, talking with you. And by the way, thanks for your patience with a vlog yesterday that did not publish on time. It was a processing error on YouTube's part, but hopefully this publishes at the correct time, 5 a.m. Mountain Time. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. Gosh. We're gonna do it.